Yo, what's going on, friends? It's Jonathan. Welcome back to another JC production where I deliver your daily dose of hotness. In this video, we're taking a look at some storage hotness. We're talking about the LaCie Too Big Dock, which I briefly touched on in my 2019 NAB roundup video. If you missed it, no worries, I'm gonna get you up to speed. The LaCie Too Big Dock is an all-in-one solution for whenever you're working at your desktop. It brings a few ports back that your laptop or desktop might be missing while doubling as external storage in optional RAID formations. LaCie gives you everything you need in the box to get started. This includes a Thunderbolt 3 cable that I wish was a little longer, a USB 3.0 adapter, external power supply, quick install guide, and also a free 1 month subscription to Adobe's Creative Cloud Suite. The free 1 month offer is going to depend on when you purchased your Too Big Dock, so just keep that in mind. The Too Big Dock just screams quality. It's made of a brushed aluminum with sharp corners and a small blue light on the front. It also packs quite a bit of heft, and when combined with the rubberized bottom, I've had zero worries of it falling off my desk. In terms of ports, you're looking at two Thunderbolt 3 ports on the back, one USB-C 3.1 port, and one DisplayPort version 1.2 that supports 720p, 1080p, and 4K displays up to 60Hz. On the front, you have a USB 3.0 Type-A port, a compact flash slot, and a UHS 2 SD card slot. You can daisy chain up to 5 additional Thunderbolt 3 devices. If you're wanting to adapt a Thunderbolt 1 or Thunderbolt 2 device to the Too Big Dock, it's possible to do so, but only on Mac, and you need to use Apple's Thunderbolt adapters to do it, like the Thunderbolt 2 to Thunderbolt 3 one that you see here. It also supports power delivery through both Thunderbolt 3 and the USB-C ports on the back, so when connected to Thunderbolt 3, you can get 15 watts of power, while the USB-C port delivers 27 watts of power. The Too Big Dock features a hardware RAID controller. On the back side, you're gonna find a button that is used for RAID synchronization and initialization. Speaking of RAID, the Too Big Dock comes pre-configured in HFS and RAID 0. However, using the LaCie RAID Manager, it can be configured to RAID 1 or JBOD. If you're on a Windows machine, you'll need to download the necessary drivers along with the RAID Manager. The software is really straightforward and easy to use. I was able to figure it out right away. LaCie also offers backup software for Mac, which will back up personal information. The Too Big Dock can be purchased in various configurations, but all of them are 2-drive only. Sizes range from 8TB up to 28TB, and every variant uses enterprise-class drives for maximum reliability. The drives can be removed by pressing a small button on the sides of each and opening up the front. The drives are hot swappable, which means you don't need to power down the Too Big Dock to replace one drive. Just make sure you're replacing it with one of equal or greater capacity and to use one of LaCie's approved third-party drives. I'll leave a link to the list in the description. The performance of the Too Big Dock is great. The advertised speeds are up to 440 megabytes per second, which is just a hair higher than what I was able to achieve. For my testing in RAID 0, I was able to achieve 438.4 megabytes read and 435.1 megabytes write while connected to my Razer Blade 15 via Thunderbolt 3. I was also able to achieve similar speeds on my MacBook Pro. When it comes to video editing, I was able to edit 4K video in Premiere with no issue, and even 8K using a proxy workflow was just fine. The Too Big Dock is audible during workloads since they are large spinning hard disk drives and not SSDs, but I didn't find it to be a huge deal. That being said, if you're going to be doing any voiceover work, I would suggest disconnecting the drive and turning it off prior, just in case. I went ahead and moved my entire Steam game library over to the RAID, and I was able to play all of my games without any issues when it comes to speeds. The games loaded fast and the performance was always consistent. Each Too Big Dock comes back with a 5-year data recovery service, giving you some peace of mind. While this isn't a cheap investment, from a content creator's perspective, I feel it's one of the most important purchases you can make. There's nothing worse than while you're working on a long project, the storage drives fail and you lose all of your work without any recovery options available. I've been really impressed with the performance I'm getting from the Too Big Dock, and having those extra ports just make my workflow that much easier. If you're interested in more information, or if you want to pick one up for yourself, I'll leave links down in the description, so make sure to check there. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a like. If you have any questions, leave them down below in the comment section. If you haven't already started following me on social, make sure to follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, and I'll talk to you not too big, not too small, storage stuffing animals, in the next video.